scored. I just filled it. But yeah. Okay. Say that again, you're talking to me.
Officials, see that the Memphis, Tennessee, the site tonight as we showcase American women's basketball. The Memphis Tigers welcome to town the Bearcats of Cincinnati here on the American Digital Network. Let's take a look at the standings coming into this final month of conference play. Of course, UConn and UCF in the driver's seat. Cincinnati's only losses have come to the top two teams ahead of them in the standings. And right now, Memphis right in the middle of that pack. So many different ways that this season can play out for the Tigers, depending on how these next few games go. On that note, we welcome you back here on ADN. Lincoln Rose along with Coach Angela Beck. For Cincinnati, a couple losses to UConn, one to UCF. And yet, as well as they have played, as easily the top, one of the top three teams in this league, they have everybody else breathing down their neck.
Well, correct. And Memphis needs to get off to a really quick start here, and they can't let this one get away because we have a red-hot Cincinnati team. They have extreme confidence in themselves. They have a new coach, a new arena, and a swag that is they're confident, and they're ready to go.
What's it going to take for them to get a win today here on the road and sweep these Tigers?
Well, they're going to feed the post, and people have had trouble with denying their post game. They want to speed up the game as fast as they can and keep that balanced scoring.
For Memphis, we actually saw them this past weekend on the American Digital Network. After watching that game, what adjustments need to be made?
Well, their defense needs to get better, and they need to mix it up and be a lot tougher on defense, number one. But go inside out, let their bigs touch the ball a little bit more, and then limit their turnovers. They turned the ball over too much last game.
Well, in terms of a player to showcase, one of the reasons why Cincinnati has been so fantastic this year has been the play of Antoinette Miller.
Well, Antoinette Miller, she was asked to step up after Anna Owens graduated last year, and she has impacted the game in a variety of reasons. 12 points, she's averaging 5.4 assists, which is second in the American, 4.8 rebounds, 2 steals. She's doing it all for them in Cincy.
Look forward to seeing her this evening in Memphis. And, of course, for the home squad Tigers, you talk about the talented youngster. And Jermyra Schutz, the only problem was 2 quick fouls back on Saturday.
Well, and she was silent, but then she comes up and she gets 16 points. So she's a prolific scorer from high school, 3,000 points in high school. She's averaging 13 points. She's had 11 times she's led Memphis in scoring. She can do it, and she's a shooter.
Her Tigers have a big opportunity with the Bearcats in town. Opening tip when we return on the American Digital Network.
How do you drive impact for 200 years? By doing it boldly. By building a bridge, breaking a barrier, planting a flag, owning a stage. Because here, we learn by doing and believe the status quo was built to be broken. So be proud. Be bold. Be Cincinnati. We're 2 centuries in, and we're still creating what's next. We are Boldly Bearcat. In a city known for doing things our way, there's a university that's driven to do the same, to blur the outdated line between academic pursuits and active ones, not just to learn, but to experience, to create, solve, build, to explore and express, to lead. Because an education isn't something you get, it's something you do.
Just about set to go. Introductions all concluded. This is your Play for K game for the Memphis Tigers, as you'll see them wearing their pink here at home. We'll be able to dive into that a little bit throughout the broadcast, of course. Most of you familiar with Kay Yao and her legacy by now. We take a look at your starting lineups, and again, for Memphis, what held them back against ECU and Greenville on Saturday was some foul concerns for 2 of their 5 starters. 2 quick fouls in the first 5 minutes for a couple of them, including Schutz, held them back early on. As for the Bearcats, again, this is a group that's been red hot and will need to continue to find success to hang on to that top 3 seed. Lincoln Rose, Angela Beck with you. And for the first time today, let's check in with Jessica Benson.
Hey, thanks, Lincoln. Talking with Cincinnati coach Michelle Clark Hurd. She has her team really just focused on the basics today, on rebounding, taking care of the basketball, and just continuing to grow as a team. This Bearcats team is firing on all cylinders. She really feels that each player on her team knows their role at this point in the season. But she did remind them that the second time you're playing a team, you always just have to be prepared for anything. Now, talking with Memphis coach Melissa McFerrin, she says it's easy to pinpoint one exact thing that her team needs needs to do better if they want any chance at getting the upset here today, and that is transition defense. She wants to see her players improve on that, to run better with Cincinnati's bigs, and to also just take a better job of stopping the ball. This Memphis team really hangs its hat on its defense, so they've been able to stop some pretty high-scoring teams this season to some pretty low games. Now, as you're watching today's game, be sure to check in on Facebook. Tell us who you're rooting for, some of your favorite players, and where you're watching from. But for now, I'll go ahead and send it back to you, Lincoln.
Jessica, thank you. A quick 2 points early on for Memphis from Brianna Porter. She's averaging about 3 points a ball game. Has already matched. It's about that. See the knee brace on her left knee. Cincinnati trying to pull it back. Shot off the mark from Sam Rogers, the junior out of Cincy. And this is an ideal start for the Tigers.
Well, that was just a great aggressive attack. And we talked earlier in the pregame that, you know, they need to get off to a quick start, and it looks good. We talked about them mixing up their defenses. Now they're in a 1-2-2 defense, and they're trapping Lena Davis. They're trapping on the block.
Extra pass from Warren. And the Bearcats on the board with the first 2 points for Thomas. And transition the other way. And just unable to hit the layup there, Antoinette Miller.
Looks like we got an injury deep behind the backboard. I'm not sure. I know she fell hard, but I didn't see. Looks like she's going to get up.
And again, that is Herndon, the junior from right here in Memphis. And her feet. Well, no.
That was peculiar. Oh, looks like it's in her gut. Huh.
Well, they hope, obviously, she'll be able to get back in. She has been a game changer for them at times, whether it be as a starter or off the bench, but nothing obvious on the replay.
Well, Cincinnati's defense has traditionally been strong, and this year it's even better because it's extremely stingy. They're only giving up 60 points a game. And they change their defenses a lot and make you think.
Miller with the rebound the other way, waiting for numbers. Memphis able to jump out to a quick 4-0 start. Cincinnati able to pull two back. Shot clock at 10. And the Bearcats now have missed a couple of opportunities to pull this ball game even early on.
Yeah, that's a good look by Amari Thomas. She's just a little strong on the backboard, but that's definitely the shot they wanted.
Amari Thomas, last year's freshman of the year in the American. Numbers game for the Tigers. Sam Rogers doing just enough to slow down Memphis there. It looked like Jada Stinson was going to have an opportunity to go right up with it.
Well, it was a 2-on-1, and they probably should have converted it, but credit Cincinnati for getting back and getting their defense set.
Michelle Clark-Hurd played her college ball at Western Kentucky. Throughout her coaching career was an assistant here at Cincinnati. Would go back and take over the reins with the Hilltoppers, and now has returned to the Bearcats for the first time as head coach with this program, inheriting a team that last year made it to the WNIT. Bearcats last year were 19-13, 12-6 in conference. And right now a 15-8 campaign, 7-3. They have decisively been the third best team in this conference this year behind UConn and UCF.
Well, she has a fiery personality. She has a lot of respect in the field. She's a proven winner. And, you know, she's a new general in town, and they've really adapted to her well.
A Oh, nice feed inside, just whipping it right in, and that leads Davis to the rim.
Well, this is a totally different looking team than what we saw the other night against ECU. This team has a lot of pep in their step, and they're playing, well, they gave one up there, but their defense has been pretty solid so far.
All of that, please, from Sam Rogers, the junior. We saw Davis scored last time down. She's coming off a career high in rebounding in that loss at ECU when she hauled in 18 boards. But Memphis looking like a completely different team here today. Jasmine James, the Canadian.
And Jasmine James in just a little stop and pop, and it looked pure.
Deja vu, good again. Back-to-back triples for Sam Rogers.
Sam Rogers is their sole, pretty much their three-point shooter. She's taken 94 threes for the year at 30%, so that's a good take for her. Better passing and better ball movement than I've seen from them.
And a turnover for Memphis. Cincinnati, their last trip down with Rogers hitting another three, has this a brand new ball game, 8 apiece. Melissa McFerrin talking things over, of course, in her 11th year, former point guard in her playing days for the Missouri Tigers. Former Patriot League Coach of the Year with American a decade back when she led them to the WNIT, of course, has had a stop as the general manager of the Washington Mystics in the WNBA as well. But she's had a nice staff around her for the past 5 to 6 years now. Good consistency. And the Bearcats have made their last three. This time, Nakira Goings getting in on the fun.
Well, Goings has heated up her offense. She's steadily progressed. And, you know, she's also a three-point shooter for him, averaging about 27%.
Nakira, the senior out of Marietta, Georgia. You'll hear us talk about seniors, juniors, and sophomores for Cincinnati. You won't hear us mention the name of a single freshman. That's not hazing. There just are no freshmen on this Cincinnati team.
And that's unusual because we've seen a lot of freshmen this year. And I think that's one reason they are good, because they don't really have young people. They have a pretty well-oiled machine.
A couple of fakes. The rebound comes down to Thomas. Memphis does a good job getting numbers back. And Nakira Goings now has caught the fever here. Back-to-back three-pointers of her own.
Well, Goings went from single-digit minutes early on the season now to getting 25 minutes a game. And coach likes what she's doing. So she's getting more minutes and she's getting more production and she's getting hot.
It's a 9-0 run for Cincinnati over the past minute and a half. And Thomas thought she got the block from behind, but instead free throws coming up. And first we'll have an official timeout before the free throws. That gives us an opportunity for the second time today to check back in with Jessica Courtson.
Thanks, Lincoln. This is exactly the start Melissa McFerrin wanted to see from her team. She really felt like the Tigers had taken a couple steps back over the last few games, and she was hoping to see a fast start today. Now, as you're watching today's game, be sure to check in with us. We're interactive here on the American Digital Network. We want to hear from you where you're watching, who you're rooting for, who your favorite players are on these two teams. So be sure to comment, and we'll follow along with you as we go through the game. I'll go ahead and send it back to you, Lincoln.
Bearcats have battled back. They've hit their last 4 three-pointers, up by 6 now on the road.
At the American, we know that power isn't for the faint of heart. Power is reserved for the go-getters, the team players, and those who are hungry for victory. We know power because we are power. Join us for the 2019 American Athletic Conference Women's Basketball Championship, March 8th through the 11th at the Mohegan Sun Arena in Uncasville, Connecticut. More than 7,000 student athletes rising to become champions in 22 different sports at 13 esteemed institutions across 11 states. 360,000 students and 2.6 million alumni. Rise up in celebration of a Power Six conference known as the American, powered by determination.
Powerful minds, strong in mind,
strong in body.
The American is dedicated
to promoting success
through a healthy, powerful mind.
If it is okay to seek help
for injuries we can see,
then it needs to be okay
to seek help for injuries
we can't see.
Mental health awareness is important because I think a lot of times it goes unnoticed in college athletics.
We look after our bodies, and it's just as important to look after our mental health.
It's time to end the stigma
related to mental health
and seeking help.
End the stigma.
Cincinnati on the road in Memphis. They are shooting just 1 of 4 inside the three-point line. However, they are a perfect 4 for 4 from downtown.
Well, Coach Hurt said she wanted to work the ball inside out. Well, this is outside in, but it's going in, and it's raining outside. Goins and Rogers, those two are the three-point shooters, and they're firing them up 2 for 2 apiece.
Rogers made the first pair. Nakira Goins showing off that she can hit from either wing. So as a result, it's a 9-0 run for Cincinnati, a 12-2 run if you want to take it further. Memphis with a chance to cut into the deficit here at the free throw line. Again, Amari Thomas was called for the foul, which puts Davis, a 70% shooter, at the charity stripe.
Well, I talked about Memphis's defense early on, that they needed to really bring intensity on it. I don't think that 1-2-2 defense is going to make it. They're shooting it out right now. So it'll be interesting to see if they switch and go to a man-to-man in order to cover those three-point shooters.
So the last 4 shots Cincinnati has taken are those 4 three-pointers they have made.
And they have moved to a man-to-man.
Miller. Antoinette Miller just lowers her shoulder, goes into lane.
I don't know what her speed is clocked at, but it's fast. And she should be definitely running track for them.
Goins contests the shot the other way, and the block shot from Puckett.
Cincinnati's well disciplined. They're not going to foul you a lot. That was a good indication of how they stay down. Good team defense. Big girl just goes up and gets it.
And you noted how Miller has stepped up for the departure of Anna Owens, outgoing senior last year. Shot clock at 5. No sweat. They've made their last 5. And let's welcome in Antoinette Miller to the three-point sorority.
Well, it's just becoming a three-point party, but I think what Melissa McFerrin's doing is she's going man-to-man miss and zone make, and they're just tearing up that zone. They're just standing, and they're getting their feet set and rocking and firing.
Well, Cincinnati's made their last 6 shots, but only one of them was a layup from Miller. They're hitting their shots.
Well, they're getting time, and they're getting distance, and when you get a shooter to get set, it's when they got rhythm, they can make it happen.
Angel Reiser and Puckett are the two Bearcats on the floor right now who haven't fired up a three-pointer. I'm sure their time will come.
What's impressive about Cincinnati and some of their wins is that is their balanced scoring attack. Many of the teams that we've seen this year have only had a couple double-figure scorers. These guys are producing 4 double-figure scorers every night.
Memphis got an easy path to the bucket, and they'll come away with some second-chance points as the rebound and putback from Jamira Schutz, the freshman from right here in Tennessee.
Well, that gets Schutz on the board and hopefully gets her active because they're a much better team when she's scoring.
Schutz, a really talented player that Melissa McFerrin will point out. She had a chance to go to several different top-flight programs. She wanted to become a Memphis Tiger.
Yeah, it said she could have gone to several SECs, and she picked Missouri and Memphis, and then obviously her final choice, Memphis, good choice, and Melissa's excited to watch her grow.
Pressure here from the Bearcats. Herndon with the dribble, one of 2 Tigers from right here in the Memphis area.
Well, I think a key to Melissa's defensive transition that she was worrying about is for them to take quality shots on this end, like that one, and that gives them time to get back.
Great passing all around from Memphis as Jasmine James, the beneficiary.
I think they've done a great job so far of getting the ball inside, in the paint, where they're good to score. And the last game, they weren't so patient with that.
You'd love to give Herndon a hockey assist there, but the lone assist will belong to Schutz. Memphis continues to find opportunities around the rim, and they'll head back to the free throw line. Once again, it'll be Davis.
I think Memphis enjoys going up against a man-to-man defense. I think they can find their rhythm better, and they do a better job of feeding their posts. And this is a man-to-man defense that Cincinnati has stayed in.
Tigers trying to take advantage of Amari Thomas, picking up two quick fouls in the first 6 minutes of this quarter. Has Thomas on the bench. You see her across the way.
Well, that's a pretty big, you know, person to have on the bench there. She does a lot for them. So first and field goal percentage in the American and sixth nationally, and she's sitting on the bench.
And a quick whistle back here on the opposite end. Called on Herndon. Cincinnati's lead at 5. Largest lead for Coach Clark Hurd's squad has been 9. There were 3 Tigers, all spectators, as Miller went right by.
Well, that was a circus-like throw, and it was like an alley-oopy, you know, underhanded scoop shot, but nice take. She had good spin on it.
She probably wins quite a few games of horse. Out muscling in another offensive putback from Davis. Mentioned she had 18 rebounds against ECU, and we saw them Saturday.
So that's 12 points in the paint right now for Memphis. So good job. That's what they need.
Back within 5 as we approach the final minute of the opening quarter in Memphis. And they are human. After Cincinnati had made its first 5 three-pointers, they finally miss. A much more modest 83% from downtown today.
that's you call being on fire, that's on fire.
Trying to shake free of the defender. Credit to Chelsea Warren for not giving up any space, but sticking with it was Schutz. Goings, there she goes again. Her third.
There's not a lot of sense of urgency with Memphis to close out on those shooters. I think they need to get out there hard and fast, and they're just kind of scooting. And so it's giving them enough time to get it off.
Nakira Goings, who is just a 27% shooter from beyond the arc, 3 for 3 today. She has not missed from the floor today. 9 points for the game high at the moment. And another stop here for Cincinnati. Their lead back up to 6. And they'll have a decent look, you imagine, inside of 4 seconds. They'll settle for half court. Well, Memphis got off to a strong start. They finished making 4 of their 5 shots to close out the quarter, but Cincinnati on fire on the road, up by 6.
This is our game, our moment, our time. We work hard and play harder. We stay loyal to the game and to our team. We are power, American power. The American, powered by determination.
Bernie scores!
3 strikeouts in a row.
dominance for a fourth straight year. Quaiso from 30!
Unbelievable!
And be able to celebrate the seventh championship.
There's the record breaker! They are the champions of the American.
Strong in mind, strong in body, strong in school, sport, life.
The grind is 10% physical and 90% mental.
The mind is the power.
The body is the means to jump higher, run faster,
be smarter, and live longer.
There is no weakness when it comes to seeking help.
We are stronger together.
So let's talk about it.
A waterfall starts with one drop.
Change starts with one person.
The American is dedicated to ending the stigma related to mental health.
And promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
Promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
Cincinnati heading into the second quarter, up 24-18. Cincinnati is 6 of 7 from beyond the arc. You know who hasn't missed a shot but has been around the floor all night long? Jessica Benson. Check in with her.
Hey, thanks, Lincoln. I asked Michelle Clark-Hurd before this game who she considers her X factor at this point in the season, and she says, I don't have one. Everyone is an X factor. There is so much depth on this team, and everyone contributes offensively, which we're already getting a taste of here tonight. The Bearcats had 5 players score in double figures in their win over Wichita State. Now, this brings us to our first trivia question of the night. The Memphis-Cincinnati matchup has the second most meetings all time in Memphis history, along with UAB. They have played each other 53 times. Memphis going into tonight led that series 35-18. So our question for you is, who's the only team that Memphis has played more than Cincinnati? Give us your best guess in the comments below, and we'll give you the answer later on in today's game. Lincoln?
And I'll give you a hint. Just think about perhaps a team that they have shared a conference with in the past. As right now, here in Memphis, Tigers down by 6, back on the defensive end. If Cincinnati struggled with anything, it's on the road. 3 road wins all year long. With that said, they've had some challenging road wins, certainly road matchups here in conference play. A trip to Orlando, a trip to Storrs, Connecticut. Conference wins on the road include so far Tulsa and USF. They're going to be tested here on the road. They go to Temple after this, go to ECU, and go to Tulane to close out their regular season.
Well, they're rolling right now because they're 6-7 from three-point range. My concern right now is that Memphis makes some adjustments and get out on those three-point shooters. They're still in this 1-2-2 that they're, you know, basically picking apart. So hopefully they can run them off the line. They have 24 points in that first quarter. Not a good sign for Memphis because they don't score that many points. Memphis is not a high-scoring team.
Well, Cincinnati hitting so many shots from outside. Those were the first free throws they'd taken today. Rogers made 1 of 2, and the Tigers able to connect with Jasmine James. Again, there's been a nice little Canadian pipeline stretching all the way down here to Memphis for Melissa McFerrin during her time. Jasmine's an outgoing senior, but we anticipate there'll be some more Canadians on the horizon. And a decisive offensive rebound for Davis. Memphis 0-for-1 from downtown before that stroke. Jamira Schutz, already a bright spot today, the freshman.
That's a good sign. Her three-point shooting, she's shooting about 23% for the year, but she's also a very streaky shooter.
7 points for Schutz for the team high. And a rare mid-range shot from Cincinnati today. Why question that? As Fofo gets in on the fun. Florence Sifa, the junior. Member of national team for Africa's Championship Cup. Played junior college ball in Texas. Had a teammate's family essentially adopt her while in the States, in the Lone Star State. Wrapping up her career in Memphis, and a little bit more from Jamira Schutz now with 9.
Well, she's going to keep shooting it until they start covering her.
Goings.
She's showing she's human.
Nobody's guarding her on the three-point line.
They still haven't been, so they're They've gotten lucky.
Maybe they got in her head by not respecting her 3-for-4 prior to that last one. And Memphis just going back to work. More from Davis.
Well, they don't. Cincinnati doesn't have an answer for Davis, so they need to keep going to Davis down low.
Memphis has erased a 9-point deficit with all the hot shooting from behind the 3-point line. That advantage is now gone.
Well, I think if you asked Coach Hurd, that's not really what she expected out of her team. I mean, she really did want to go inside and then go out. And now that they've hit a few, they keep firing them. And I think she's probably going to start trying to get shots around the rim.
I'm just going to take a wild guess that Angel Reiser plays with contact lenses.
I don't know how you got so smart.
So that will have her out for the moment.
I like they're overloading, they're screening the zone, they're rotating behind the zone, and I'm not sure that was a pass, but.
How about some third chance points? No, 0-for-3 that time down for Cincinnati. I don't know if they had missed much more than 3 shots the entire game before then.
That's Amari Thomas, and she doesn't usually miss those.
It started with a rare miss from Rogers. Thomas with a couple of options. And playing the role of goalkeeper this evening for the Bearcats is Ilea Green out of Louisville. But they'll call it a kick ball, and shot clock's going to stay at 16.
So Amari Thomas is back in with the 2 fouls, so it'll be interesting to see if Memphis attacks her.
They saw that lead start to evaporate, vulnerable in the post with Thomas out.
They need to go to her down low, ISO.
Thomas immediately paying off with the rebound. Rogers and Goings. Rogers and Goings are combined now. 5 of 7 from beyond the arc. So naturally it was Miller who fired one up. Goings got it. Her 4th triple of the half.
Well, it wasn't working for her on the right side, so she moved to the left side and drilled it.
You see the number there. It has helped define Cincinnati's game on the road today. Goings alone has 12 points in just 9 minutes.
That's how you stop defensive transition, not turning the ball over.
Jamire Schutz was not going to concede the easy layup. Free throws coming up.
Yeah, the way they set up their zone, if you turn it over at the top, with their speed, there is no defensive transition. It's hard to catch Goings. I mean, she's fast.
Akira Goings, just short of an 80% free throw shooter, making her 15th start on the year.
Alyssa's been upset because they have lost a couple games at home here as of late, and that's not really characteristic of what they do. And so they really need to correct that, and this is why she's really focused on this game here.
One lucky fan tonight will be receiving a free 43-inch TV. Memphis tweeted that out. Not sure if you have room in your checked bag or your carry-on luggage.
Well, I have room for a 70-inch.
Ah.
No. It probably cost you too much to put that in storage.
I speculated whether if it was a good old-fashioned tube TV, if even a student in great debt would even accept it. Great to have you with us on this Wednesday evening in the American. Cincinnati, after seeing their lead evaporate, back up by 5, looking for a stop here. Off the foot, and just some bad luck there. This is going to stay on this end, but with only 3 seconds on the shot clock for Memphis.
Cincinnati's playing on the high side of the post that the guards need to dribble down to the baseline in order to enter that ball. It's there, but they're not moving enough.
Herndon fires one up to beat the clock. It's good. That's just the third three-pointer Memphis is trying today. They've made a pair now, including Herndon under distress.
Well, that was a great drawn-up play.
Rogers with 7 points, tied with Miller for second on the team behind Goings with her 14, but Goings is on the bench right now. Nakira getting a well-deserved breather. And it's Fofo. That won't go down. Again, another rebound for Davis. You pointed out Imari Thomas on the floor right now for Cincinnati, playing with two fouls, and that's going to be one of the easier rebounds she has all night. Just came right to her. And perhaps one dribble too many. Left-handed scoop and good. Once again, a brand new ball game with 4 minutes to go until halftime.
I like the pace of play. I like the fact that they're pushing the tempo.
But they hit Rogers in stride. She collects and fires another three for Rogers. She's now a perfect 3-for-3.
Yeah, a little more pressure on the ball, a little more hand in the face. They can't give these guards clear vision of everything.
And Fofo Sifa doing a nice job shutting down Davis on that pass. So the Tigers twice have been able to erase some deficits. Cincinnati at the moment inches back up by three inside 4 minutes to go. Gives us another chance to check back in with Jessica Benson.
Yeah, Lincoln, despite that straight three fireball shooting from Cincinnati, Memphis is managing to stay in this ballgame. And it goes with what I talked with Melissa McFerrin about this morning. She said this team is good. It has the potential to be more successful than they're at. And that's why she's been so disappointed with the way they've fallen out the last couple of games. But she said it would be up to her team to decide if they were going to come out here and hang with Cincinnati tonight. She's looking for leadership. She's looking for maturity. And she's seeing it from the Tigers here so far today. Today, Lincoln.
Well, and of course, her top two scorers right now are a sophomore and a freshman in Davis and Schutz. She has the foundation in place moving forward. Right now, her Tigers back within three here in Memphis.
At the American, we know that power isn't for the faint of heart. Power is reserved for the go-getters, the team players, and those who are hungry for victory. We know power because we are power. Join us for the 2019 American Athletic Conference Women's Basketball Championship, March 8th through the 11th at the Mohegan Sun Arena in Uncasville, Connecticut.
For a fourth straight year.
Quaso from 30!
Unbelievable!
And be able to celebrate the second championship.
There's the record breaker! They are the champions of the American.
Power comes in all forms.
Power is a big tackle,
a big save, a clutch hit,
or a game-winning shot.
Power is also standing up for what is right.
There is power in the sportsmanship that is displayed across the American.
Power is respecting opponents,
officials,
student athletes,
coaches, and team representatives.
Power is not tolerating racial or ethnic comments,
profanities, or other improper actions while at the game.
The American.
Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
Well, despite giving up 8 3-pointers to Cincinnati around the perimeter already in this first half, Memphis is still hanging in there in part because they're taking their opportunities down low.
Well, yeah, they're going down low. That time to Porter, she had good hands. Obviously, Davis is the key player, number 33. When she gets it, it's one and done. And there's a nice backdoor pass to Schutz, who flips it over to James for the score. So, the passing was much better, and the interior passing was great, and they forced these guys to put it down.
Rogers looking to go with the heat check, has yet to miss tonight.
Well, there's not enough pressure on the basketball. If you pressure the ball, then they can't see that person all the way across the court. They're giving them these direct line passes that are setting up the shooters.
Sam Rogers is 4 for 4 from downtown Memphis. That's 9 triples for the Bearcats already.
Yeah, so their theory is, hey, you can go get those 2 points all you want because we're going to shoot 3. And if that continues, it's going to be tough.
Each time we are amazed how open the shooters are for Cincinnati.
Well, Cincinnati's done a good job. Their 16 points have come off their bench. So you talk about depth. They're bringing them in, and everyone's confident. It seems like the rhythm stays the same, and they're all scorers.
Davis, the offensive rebound, put back, no. And Miller, who is dwarfed down in the low post, somehow gets the rebound, and the Bearcats an easy one on the opposite end.
Yeah, that's a little extra step on that one, but the whole fact is that on that rebound, there were 3 Bearcats ahead of everybody.
The riser scores on one end, and Fofo Sifa draws the charge on the opposite end to get it back for the Bearcats.
Oh, I mean, that's just not a good sign when you got 3 Cincinnati players beating the rest of your players down, and it has to do with what type of shot you shoot.
Cincinnati's led by as many as 9. Memphis has erased that deficit, and now the Bearcats have regrown it to an 8-point advantage. Miller, nice screen from Reiser, and Miller will go to the free throw line to try to make this a double-digit lead.
Well, Miller, she's crafty. She averages 5.6 assists a game, which is 2nd in the American. That's a lot of assists in a game. So not only is she dangerous taking it to the hole, but she can dish it off just as well.
I'm not impressed. That just means you're passing it to 3-point shooters around the perimeter.
True. And they're
it's
making
an assist
them.
Every single time. As Miller makes the front end. Bearcats are 4 of 5 from the charity stripe today.
Not a lot of fouls called in this game so far. Pretty clean game. Turnovers are decent. 8 for Memphis and only 5 for Cincinnati.
Bearcats have gone with a 9-player rotation right now. Memphis, we've seen 7 different Tigers in the pink uniforms tonight. Shoots. Stuck on 9 points at the moment. But he knows quickly got back on defense. Rogers. Oh, misses for the first time today. Now 4 for 5. That would have tied her career high that she set last month against SMU when she connected on 5. He still has, I'm told, a little bit more time in this ball game to try to find that 5th 3-pointer.
She's got a few more minutes. But once again, they're off to a pretty fast-paced, high-scoring quarter. They have 18 points in the quarter already, which, like I say, is not a good sign because they need to slow that down.
Florence Sifa from Burundi went to, again, Jacksonville Junior College in Texas first couple of years. Junior now here with the Bearcats with 1 more year of eligibility left. About a 60% free throw shooter, able to make 1 of 2. And you see the pressure from the Bearcats. And it forces a turnover. Well, that just reminds me of how well things are going for Memphis today as compared to in Greenville against ECU on Saturday.
Well, yeah, but if they start extending their pressure, you don't know. That was the first time we've seen them extend pressure, and they needed to settle down a little bit and make a read.
Those turnovers were way too common, but you could credit LaShonda Monk and company. Inside to Reiser. Tigers able to clamp down. As Porter with the rebound and draws out the foul on Cincinnati.
Yeah, that was a little reach-in foul. A little bit ticky-tacky, but still a good call. Minute 32, they're trying to make a big run here, Cincinnati is, by putting them away.
I'm surprised that didn't go in off Sam Rogers' foot. She's had the touch.
Yeah.
Eight able to clamp down. Down by 11. And the Bearcats, again, are being rewarded for their effort. Sifa again draws out another offensive foul on the Tigers.
Yeah, I mean, she extended the elbow out to get clearance and knocked her down. So, I mean, this last minute 20, it's really important that Memphis get a couple stops here so they don't go in the locker room with a huge lead here.
Well, teams are shooting right around 50% here for the ball game. Cincinnati has made 9 3-pointers. Tigers have made a pair. Sifa, mid-range, money.
I like that little shot fake stop and pop she's got.
And this time a foul on the Bearcats. Cincinnati right now with that score from Sifa on a 13-0 run over the past 3 minutes. And that's your difference right now in this ball game. It was 32-32. And then the turnover bug bit the Tigers a few times.
Yeah, the turnover and a couple missed shots, and there you have it. But I feel like Cincinnati's playing this last minute like they can get a few more points. And I feel like Memphis is just trying to get in the locker room.
Final minute of the opening half. And they'll take the shot off the bank. That'll end a drought where Memphis had more turnovers than shots attempted.
They've had a couple of those shots today.
That's the benefit of being the home team. Eight seconds between the two clocks. And this back over to Memphis. Again, this is Memphis's Play for K game. Play for K, the largest fundraising initiative under the K-Yao Cancer Fund, which since starting in 2007 has awarded over $7.5 million to support scientific research and projects that serve the underserved in all cancers affecting women. Of course, Hey Yao, Naismith Hall of Fame coach, Olympic gold medal winning head coach as well. It's easy to forget that she was diagnosed in 87. We lost her in 2009. As they will whistle off the basket. But Play for K is something that you have seen, just it seems like almost every team in the country truly embrace. It is a cause that affects almost every family in America. You either know somebody or related somebody. Right now, we have reached halftime. Cincinnati closes it out on a 13-2 run. Bearcats at 7-3 in conference still have the rest of the league breathing down their necks, but Michelle Clark Hurd has to be happy with what she saw. She's with our Jessica Benson courtside.
Thanks, Lincoln. Coach, you had that half on a 13-2 run. What started to click for you guys?
Well, I think we're just trying to focus on our defense more. We got to rebound better. And so we just try to focus on that, make sure we can take care of the basketball.
Offensively, 9 threes. How did that outside shooting help open up your offense?
Yes, it did. But I told them we got to still get back to going inside out. But really glad that the ball's falling in the hole for us from the three-point line.
Thanks, Coach. Appreciate it. Lincoln.
Thank you. Appreciate Coach Clark Hurd's time. We'll hear from Melissa McFerrin right before the start of the third quarter. But first, when we come back here on the American Digital Network, we'll take a look around the league with some weekly honors as well as highlights and stats.
How do you drive impact for 200 years? By doing it boldly. By building a bridge, breaking a barrier, planting a flag, owning a stage. Because here, we learn by doing and believe the status quo was built to be broken. So be proud, be bold, be Cincinnati. We're two centuries in, and we're still creating what's next. We are Boldly Bearcat.
I wouldn't say I really model my game after anybody, but I've always been like a huge fan of like Derrick Rose. He's always been one of my favorite players growing up, so.
What's better, winning by a buzzer beater or blowing a team out?
Definitely winning by a buzzer beater. I think that it's far more fun playing a close game. When you're able to play in that tough game and compete to the last second, is very exciting.
What's your favorite Fortnite dance?
Can I get up and knock it out?
I wish you would. What's the best Netflix series?
Grey's Anatomy. I've watched that for years now, and it just keeps getting better and better. UC.
In a city known for doing things our way, there's a university that's driven to do the same, to blur the outdated line between academic pursuits and active ones, not just to learn, but to experience, to create, solve, build, to explore and express, to lead. Because an education isn't something you get, it's something you do.
Basketball days are over. My dream is probably to be a CFO of a company somewhere, any company really. The emoji I probably use the most is the probably the two-eye emoji, just the eyes emoji, because I like to be like, you know, there's a little sketchy stuff going on. So I love horses. I grew up around horses. I love riding horses. So definitely riding horses and being around horses is my secret talent slash interest. The best advice I've ever received would definitely be every day you wake up, you have a clean slate. So every day you get to wake up and make your own reality, whatever you want it to be. You get to wake up every day and be something different if you want. It means everything to me to put on Memphis. I'm not originally from Memphis, but I kind of grew up in Memphis. So I take pride in putting the Memphis across my chest every time I walk out there. Go Tigers, go!
This is our game, our moment, our time. We work hard and play harder. We stay loyal to the game and to our team. We are power, American power. The American, powered by determination. More than 7,000 student athletes rising to become champions in 22 different sports at 13 esteemed institutions across 11 states. 360,000 students and 2.6 million alumni rise up in celebration of a Power Six conference known as the American, powered by determination.
Powerful minds.
Strong in mind.
Strong in body.
The American is dedicated
to promoting success
through a healthy, powerful mind.
If it is okay to seek help
for injuries we can see,
then it needs to be okay
to seek help for injuries we can't see.
Mental health awareness is important because I think a lot of times it goes unnoticed in college athletics.
We look after our bodies, and it's just as important to look after our mental health.
It's time to end the stigma
related to mental health
and seeking help.
End the stigma.
And we welcome you back to Memphis as you take a look at the Hernando de Soto Bridge here in town. As a chance for us, while these two teams are at the half, to take a look back at your honorees this past week, including for a second time the last 3 weeks, Nafisa Collier at UConn, your player of the week in the American.
Well, it's the third time she's gotten player of the week, and it's the league best ever. She averaged 25 points, 9 boards, 4.5 assists, and 3 blocks last week, shooting 84% from the field in 2 UConn wins. But she also had a season-high 30 points and 14 rebounds versus Temple.
course, UConn remains unbeaten in conference play. Meanwhile, you look at the freshman of the week in the American, and Marissa Mackins had herself quite a week with the Owls of Temple.
Yeah, they split it last week, but they had a win over Houston. She averaged 12.5 points, 2 boards, 3.5 assists, and she had double digits against UConn.
Marissa Mackins, your freshman of the week. Nafisa Collier, your player of the week. Congratulations to both of those talented student athletes. First half highlights and stats from Memphis when we return here on the American Digital Network. For a fourth straight year. Queso from 30!
Unbelievable!
And be able to celebrate this type of championship.
There's the record breaker. They are the champions of the American.
Strong in mind, strong in body, strong in school, sport, life.
The grind is 10% physical and 90% mental.
The mind is the power.
The body is a means to jump higher, run faster,
be smarter, and live longer.
There is no weakness when it comes to seeking help.
We are stronger together.
So let's talk about it.
A waterfall starts with one drop.
Change starts with one person.
The American is dedicated to ending the stigma related to mental health.
And promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
Promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
Power comes in all forms.
Power is a big tackle,
a big save,
a clutch hit,
or a game-winning shot.
Power is also standing up for what is right.
There is power in the sportsmanship that is displayed across the American.
Power is respecting opponents,
officials,
student athletes,
coaches, and team representatives. Power is not tolerating racial or ethnic comments,
profanities, or other improper actions while at the game.
The American.
Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
At the American, we know that power isn't for the faint of heart. Power is reserved for the go-getters, the team players, and those who are hungry for victory. We know power because we are power. Join us for the 2019 American Athletic Conference Women's Basketball Championship, March 8th through the 11th at the Mohegan Sun Arena in Uncasville, Connecticut.
How do you drive impact for 200 years? By doing it boldly. By building a bridge, breaking a barrier, planting a flag, owning a stage. Because here, we learn by doing. And believe the status quo was built to be broken. So be proud. Be bold. Be Cincinnati. We're 2 centuries in, and we're still creating what's next. We are Boldly Bearcat. In a city known for doing things our way, there's a university that's driven to do the same, to blur the outdated line between academic pursuits and active ones, not just to learn, but to experience, to create, solve, build, to explore and express, to lead. Because an education isn't something you get, it's something you do.
Halftime here in Memphis says it was 32-32, but the Bearcats close out the second quarter on a 13-2 run. We welcome you back here on the American Digital Network. Lincoln Rose along with Angela Beck. And with it being mid-February, we are already closing in on the home stretch here in conference play. Both these teams hoping to hit their stride. Bearcats do a nice job showing up here on the road, trying to continue their winning ways.
Pretty good first half, really. Maybe gave up a few too many points if you're Memphis, giving them 20 points, but they were raining it down at three-point range. Everybody who touched it, and then we have a little backdoor pass for Memphis because they owned the paint. They just didn't get quite enough points in it. Kind of fell asleep at the last of the second half, second quarter, and gave up a few too many there.
Goings with a team-high 14 points. Rogers with 13 points. Both of them were 4 of 6 from beyond the arc. Memphis, though, while Imari Thomas was saddled with two fouls early on, took advantage of her absence. But you saw Thomas did come back in, played disciplined, never picked up that third foul.
Well, I thought Cincinnati played extremely disciplined, and 11 assists. It doesn't show right there, but they had 11 assists. That's a lot of assists. But Cincinnati, both teams shot the ball well. Only five turnovers. I mean, that shows you discipline right there, and points off turnovers.
Yeah, those points off turnovers, a lot of that came around near that closing moments of the first half when Cincinnati was able to take advantage of some miscues from Memphis. When we come back, a chance to talk to Memphis head coach Melissa McFerrin. Well, the debate, cattle or pork?
How do you drive impact for 200 years? By doing it boldly. By building a bridge, breaking a barrier, planting a flag, owning a stage. Because here, we learn by doing and believe the status quo was built to be broken. So be proud. Be bold. Be Cincinnati. We're two centuries in, and we're still creating what's next. We are Boldly Bearcat. In a city known for doing things our way, there's a university that's driven to do the same, to blur the outdated line between academic pursuits and active ones. Not just to learn, but to experience, to create, solve, build, to explore and express, to lead. Because an education isn't something you get, it's something you do.
Dominance for a fourth straight year. Quacho from 30.
Unbelievable.
And be able to celebrate the second championship.
There's the record breaker. They are the champions of the American.
Tigers coming back home looking for a bounce back game. They shoot 50% in the first half, but find themselves trailing going into the third quarter. Melissa McFerrin, head coach of the Tigers, is now with Jessica.
Thanks, Lincoln. Coach, turnover's a killer for you guys there down the stretch. How do you clean things up in the second half?
Well, I think we just have to have a greater sense of urgency about getting shots. I talked with a couple of our guards a couple times about we can't do two in a row. If you turn one over, you got to be much more cautious the next time.
You had them tied there halfway through the second quarter. What was your message to the team in the locker room?
Well, that if we can get in defensive transition and run the three-point shooters off the line, then that point total comes down. We know we're in the right defense, but we got to find the shooters.
Thanks so much, Coach. Lincoln.
That's good. Thank you again. Nice thing here in the American, getting to hear from all the head coaches, both when we talk to them during the week in our conference calls, but also in game around halftime. Of course, Jessica will have a chance to talk to the winning head coach upon the conclusion of this broadcast before we sign off. Right now, Cincinnati up by 11 against Memphis here on the road for the Bearcats. But Cincinnati is a team that was picked fifth in this conference. Obviously, a top four seed means you play one fewer day in the conference tournament. You get that first round bye. Most people expect UConn to be the top seed, so then you really want to lock up a three seed where Cincinnati is so that you can, if you collide with UConn, do it in the final rather than the semifinals.
Yes, if you're in the top part of the bracket, you want the second or the third seed, exactly where Cincinnati's positioned. This is a big, you know, game for them because they don't want to drop down to fourth because you will be facing them. You will be facing UConn. But I'll tell you what I'm impressed with Cincinnati. They limit their turnovers. They don't foul unnecessarily. They show great discipline. They mix it up. They have a lot of speed. They have, you know, if Amari Thomas doesn't get in foul trouble, I think you even see a bigger spread here. But if that foul trouble put her on the bench, other than that, they played a pretty perfect half.
In Cincinnati, we talked about that reinvigorated arena there at Fifth Third Arena up in Cincinnati, which everybody has praised what an environment that is. So you have essentially a new venue, a new head coach, but with no new freshmen. Coach Michelle Clark-Hurd was able to minimize really the adjustments needed this year for some student athletes. With that said, did bring in some transfers. but at least they have college basketball experience. But that has helped this year smooth things out, and a turnover from the Tigers early. Miller goes around Davis.
A very good passing team. Just find the open player, look for the open shot.
And Antoinette Miller has that ball tipped out to her, and Davis just wrong place, wrong time, called for the foul.
I think for Memphis, their grade on that first half was they did rebound the ball well. They had a few too many turnovers, but they went in the paint like they really needed to. They just need to play a little better defense.
Inside out to Goings. But one and done, Davis does secure this rebound.
I like it when they press tempo, too. Push the tempo.
Well, no, Memphis has two players with three fouls, Herndon and Schutz, and Melissa McFerrin's going to trust both of them to just play through it. For Cincinnati, both Miller and Thomas on the court right now with two fouls. Nobody else in this ballgame with more than one whistle.
Well, Cincinnati finds their three-point shooters when they're in transition and with that skip pass to the opposite side, and that's what I think that Memphis could do a little bit better, too.
Reiser driving. And Angel Reiser will go to the free throw line. The North Carolina native, and in her junior campaign, makes about two-thirds of her opportunities from the charity stripe, giving the Bearcats 8 points per ball game this year. Remember, it's a Bearcats team being led by Imari Thomas, a sophomore, and the junior Antoinette Miller in double digits. Nakira Goings has been flirting with 10 points a ball game throughout the year. Just a shade under right now.
They don't look for Reiser just for offense. They look for her defense and then her ability to find the open player.
Last time we saw Cincinnati, it was their game at USF. That was a one-point victory in Tampa. That's a team you have to get a win this year against the Bulls while they're down with some injuries as Davis pours in the pair there. But that game came right after the Bearcats beat Memphis in Cincinnati. And Michelle Clark-Hurd looked back at that game, was really proud of how her defense played for the Bearcats in that one. And speaking of defense, Reiser fights for that ball. And a nice stroke taking advantage from Antoinette Miller.
Yeah, I mean, that's almost a turnover. I just think a little more tenacity, a little bit more focus, they get that turnover.
Rogers came to help and pick up the foul.
Yeah, they've been working the short corner against Cincinnati's defense, and that short corner's been open, so they've been able to hit their bigs. That time they got Porter.
Well, note as part of the Play for K National Free Throw Challenge, fans have the opportunity to pledge per free throw made by their team during this month of February. You can find more information at KYOW.com. A 11-point lead right now for the Bearcats. Not quite 3 minutes into the third quarter. Inside to Thomas.
Well, great patience, great execution. The ball didn't hit the floor to dribble in that series. And there's a good transition bucket. That's what they need is more pace and more transition.
Jada Stinson able to answer. The sophomore out of Elizabethtown High School in Kentucky. But the Bearcats go inside, get it right back with Maury Mari Thomas. Open look for three, just won't go down for Stinson. But it stays here with the Tigers.
Well, they're getting pretty easy buckets inside, so you can expect Cincinnati to keep hammering it in down low.
Mentioned with the talented young players that Melissa McFerrin has. By the way, how many head coaches do you see range all the way down to the baseline? Well, Melissa McFerrin can cover a lot of ground.
She does. She covers a lot. She even gets out on the floor a little bit.
And a former point guard in her own days, as she's going to have Jamira Schutz for three more seasons after this one, a talented youngster. But I know already the foundation with some young players here at Memphis and, of course, some smart student-athletes. That's something that Coach McFerrin rightfully is particularly proud of.
Well, Schutz has 11 points, 4 assists already.
And Goings stretches it to a 15-point lead. Schutz.
It's the Schutz and Davis show.
The latter of which just off the mark right there. The offensive rebound for Porter. Bearcats numbers the other way. But there's your transition defense slowing them down. A great effort from Herndon.
Yeah, Herndon got in the passing lane and caught up and just batted that ball out of bounds. But look at they're sleeping. I mean, no one closed out on that shooter.
Thomas offensive rebound.
That's just
two more easy points. Would love to see her shot chart tonight.
Well, she's got a lot of nifty moves in there.
She's got 8 points, all of them right around the rim. That goes with 7 rebounds for Imari Thomas.
Watch Cincinnati just run the floor. You've got 4 against 3 right now.
Thomas with a miss. Davis with her 8th rebound now. Too shy of a double-double with her 10 points. And the Tigers had a couple of looks. Second chance there from Porter wouldn't go. Antoinette Miller.
Well, 101 means get ball stopped quickly, and no one stopped the ball. So she was able to get to the rim, and they're pushing. And I'll tell you what, when they go to the bench right now, they're going to push it even harder.
Biggest lead of the ball game belongs to Cincinnati, up by 17 here on the road. And again, this timeout gives us a chance to check back in with Jessica Benson. Jessica?
Thanks, Lincoln. You've talked about the young foundation this Memphis Tigers team has between Jamira Schutz and Alana Davis. And you just said it, Alana Davis just pulled down her 8th rebound of this game. She has 10 points. But last weekend against ECU, she racked in her 8th double-double of the season, the 12th of her career. So that brings us to this trivia question of the night. Where does that stand in the Americans' rankings this season of double-double? Give us your best guesses in the comments below, and we'll give you the answer later on in today's game. Lincoln?
Thank you. We'll give the viewers a little bit of time to think about it and have the answer to an earlier trivia question when we come back here on the American Digital Network.
This is our game, our moment, our time. We work hard and play harder. We stay loyal to the game and to our team. We are power, American power. The American, powered by determination. More than 7,000 student athletes rising to become champions in 22 different sports at 13 esteemed institutions across 11 states. 360,000 students and 2.6 million alumni rise up in celebration of a Power Six conference known as the American, powered by determination.
Powerful minds, strong in mind,
strong in body.
The American is dedicated
to promoting success
through a healthy, powerful mind.
If it is okay to seek help,
for injuries we can see, then it needs to be okay
to seek help for injuries
we can't see.
Mental health awareness is important because I think a lot of times it goes unnoticed in college athletics.
We look after our bodies, and it's just as important to look after our mental health.
It's time to end the stigma.
Related to mental health
and seeking help.
End the stigma.
The 54th all-time meeting between these two programs. It's the Tigers who historically lead the series 35-18, but the Bearcats right now with their largest lead of the day. We will see Memphis again this weekend in New Orleans. Our last chance to see Lisa Stockton's group here on the American Digital Network. Second to last week of the regular season coming up. We'll also see the Owls at Dallas to close out our schedule here on ADN.
Yeah, Memphis has won the series so far, but last four games have been owned by the Bearcats.
The Tigers have only played Southern Miss more times than they have played Cincinnati. They've met Southern Miss 57 times. Rogers. And a fresh shot clock for the Bearcats. And they say did not keep that left foot planted. The travel called on Puckett. Memphis and Cincinnati actually didn't play for an 8-year stretch from 06 to 2013 until they rejoined the same conference. Cincinnati has won the last four meetings, however, in this rivalry. And trying to make it five in a row here.
Coach Hurd didn't like how they came out that time at all.
Again, we got to see Memphis against ECU on Saturday in Greenville. This is a much better looking squad, at least early on. They limited the turnovers. They limited the foul concerns against LaShonda Monk and company. But ultimately, Cincinnati was just red hot that everything Memphis was doing well, the Bearcats were able to answer.
Yeah, and they missed a few shots here, like one of seven of the last opportunities. Then they dig a hole. So they have to I think they have to change the tempo a little bit and up their intensity.
Let's remind you where these teams are in the standings right now. Cincinnati with just three losses. A couple games back of UCF, likely nestled into that third spot. Houston had a big win the other day because all of a sudden they saw some teams right behind them turn some heads. Tulsa is clicking. They were able to take advantage of a Tulane loss, and all of a sudden they are fifth in the league. Memphis let one slip away against ECU, who's climbing up into the pack as well. But we had some head turners on Saturday and Sunday that all of a sudden have made this a lot more congested from three on down.
Well, as Melissa McFerrin said, the muck is starting to separate a bit. Although you have those three teams clogged at 4-6, that's why this game's so important, because if Memphis loses here, they go back to 4-7 and they're in the bottom of the muck.
Houston needed a comeback to beat USF. Otherwise, we are talking about a five-loss Houston team as well, along with these six-loss squads, including Memphis. It'll be interesting to see how the next couple of weeks play out here in the American.
I think there's someone on Memphis's team that just needs to ignite them, get a steal, you know, make something happen. They're going to have to extend their defense, although I don't know if they have the energy to do it. There's just not a lot of pep in Memphis's step.
We saw a few more turnovers at the end of the first half and to start the third quarter for Memphis. 13 turnovers compared to just six for Cincinnati right now. That's basically your difference, because Memphis is still shooting fairly well, a little under 50% for the ball game.
Yeah, Cincinnati's though, six of their last eight, and a lot of them have been pretty easy baskets, like up the middle with bank, you know, just layups. So they're going to have to make them shoot more difficult shots and get a couple stops right here.
And Memphis is still out-rebounding, thanks in part to Davis. Cincinnati. Tigers basketball, a chance to get something going here in the final 4 minutes of the third quarter at home.
Well, Schutz and Davis are the key. They really need to rock and fire here. I like that.
Tigers after today, road swing again to Tulane. We'll have that here on American Digital Network. And then I'm told there's a team up in Connecticut that's also a member of this conference.
I think I know them.
team. Connecticut had a nice, UConn had a nice bounce back win in non-conference play after they played some powerhouses. I know folks like, we saw that smack talk feature over with ESPN between those two squads. Sue Bird on the wrong end of things.
These Cincinnati guards do have a lot of speed. I mean, their acceleration is quite fast. So back into this 1-2-2 zone. Which to me, I think, you know, it's just giving them too much time and freedom.
Miller, step inside the arc. No. And again, Memphis, their strength has been rebounding today. Three Bearcat starters in double figures. Nakira Goings has the game-high 16. Both Rogers and Miller with 13 points apiece. Miller's added 5 rebounds. Imari Thomas, 8 and 7 per line. We'll note Miller with 8 assists as well. She could wind up with a triple-double, depending on how many times she has the opportunity to rebound a ball. This time, pass over to Goings.
Very methodical, very patient.
Shot clock at 10. See Camille Buckingham, who initially going for the ball, but wound up rebounding herself a Bearcat. Into Rogers. That's the one play you don't want to give up. Simply right below the bucket on the inbounds.
Rogers kind of the unsung hero. She's just, she makes it flow. She keeps moving the ball, finds the open man, hits the open shot.
They find the 6'2 freshman. Nice job by Memphis there with Camille Buchanan. Reiser slams on the brakes.
Well, just on that little drive by Reiser, no one contested that shot. She just elevated and shot it.
Well, now all of a sudden, shots on both ends, past 4 possessions. Teams finding points down low. Back to Buchanan.
That's good and fine, but you really can't trade buckets here, so they need to stop desperately.
Buchanan's only played 3 minutes so far, already has more points than minutes played. At times, he's against Cincinnati with an easy bucket. So Memphis is scoring, but they're not stopping the Bearcats. And free throws coming up for Jamyra Schutz.
Well, Schutz, she's a very intelligent player, high IQ, understands, hey, she needs to make something happen. Out of timeout, she's the one taking the shot. So she's not scared of what this moment or what she has to do. She just needs a little more help.
Tigers' last win was against Tulsa earlier this month on Groundhog Day. That was a game where Schutz really imposed her will. That was the difference in a 3-point win for Memphis. As we see Amari Thomas get a breather. Yeah, no Bearcat with more than 2 fouls right now. Memphis still playing both Herndon and Schutz with 3 whistles. Both have been playing discipline so far. And Memphis back within 15.
What Cincinnati does is they close out that fourth quarter. If you look at their box scores, really strong. So it'll be interesting to see how they close out this fourth quarter.
Goings gone. Her 5th 3-pointer today.
She likes the deep corner. It's one of the toughest shots on the floor. Is that deep corner.
Yeah, you don't have the benefit of the ball banking in if you don't measure it right. All or nothing. A decent look there from White. Rudy White, freshman out of Pensacola. Nice extra pass.
Oh my, that right there is a highlight reel. Little stutter, gets inside the defense and then pitches it for the score.
Bucket the beneficiary on the opposite end for the Bearcats. And the Tigers are one and done.
Another loose ball.
Cincinnati has outscored Memphis this quarter 24-15. They have grown the lead up to 20 for the first time today.
Well, it's their third consecutive 20-point scoring quarter.
And after making their last five shots, finally a miss from the Bearcats, but they will head into quarter number four on the road, looking for just their fourth road victory all year long. The Bearcats in good shape, up by 20.
How do you drive impact for 200 years? By doing it boldly. By building a bridge, breaking a barrier, planting a flag, owning a stage. Because here, we learn by doing and believe the status quo was built to be broken. So be proud. Be bold. Be Cincinnati. We're two centuries in, and we're still creating what's next. We are Boldly Bearcat. In a city known for doing things our way, there's a university that's driven to do the same, to blur the outdated line between academic pursuits and active ones, not just to learn, but to experience, to create, solve, build, to explore and express, to lead. Because an education isn't something you get, it's something you do.
Power comes in all forms.
Power is a big tackle,
a big save,
a clutch hit,
or a game-winning shot.
Power is also standing up for what is right.
There is power in the sportsmanship that is displayed across the American.
Power is respecting opponents,
officials,
student athletes,
coaches, and team representatives.
Power is not tolerating racial or ethnic comments,
profanities, or other improper actions while at the game.
The American.
Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
The American.
Power for life.
Well, often when you see a coaching change, it's because there are zero expectations because of recent struggles. But Michelle Clark Hurd took over a program that was one win shy of a 20-win campaign last year. They went to the WNIT. And so there were high expectations when she returned to Cincinnati, where she had previously been an assistant. And so far, the Bearcats have been up to the challenge this year. Right now, sitting in third in conference. Let's check back in with Jessica Benson.
Thanks, Lincoln. I talked with Coach before the game, and I asked her if her team is playing at or better than what she expected them to be at this point in February. And she said probably a little bit better. She's been pleasantly surprised with how they've continued to develop as the season's gone on, just like they've been able to develop in today's game. As you've seen them start to set into their rhythm, Coach has been really excited on the sidelines, very animated. He's very excited about how they continue to feed the post now to match their outside shooting as well. And so you continue to see this Cincinnati team start to fire on all cylinders as they move forward towards the American Conference Tournament. Lincoln?
Coach, as at the helm of Western Kentucky, again, her alma mater led them to four NCAA tournaments, winning six titles altogether during her time there, a couple of regular season as well as four tournament titles with the automatic bid. Looking to get Cincinnati back into the NCAA tournament.
Well, people praise her work ethic and her basketball IQ. She has a good X and O brain. But I'm impressed, too, with just the way she has taken a team that wasn't hers and, found a way to continue to win. Even if you're talented, doesn't mean you can put a winning program together. And
we mentioned they had 19 wins last year, a lot of players returning, but most of these players are actually in different roles this year, but were quick to embrace the opportunity.
As she said, putting Mort Reiser at the three really makes them a matchup difficulty for other teams. I think the only question mark I have is if Amari Thomas gets it hurt. She's only 5'10". I mean, if they come up against a bigger team that can pound it down low, they have a difficult time. But so far they've been able to masquerade that.
Inside, and a little bit of good news for the Tigers. Davis adds to her night with a free throw coming up. Yeah, other teams with size. Obviously, UConn has size. And UCF with a talented youngster as well with Kaba.
Yeah, I mean, I think they play good enough team defense to help, you know, get it, keep it out of the paint. But I don't, you know, I just don't know if you know, if she gets in foul trouble like she did tonight, they really had nowhere to go.
So Memphis starts off with the first 3 points here in the fourth quarter. See if they can come up with some stomps. Sifa. And they'll get a bump on Davis. It's just going to be the second foul on Davis.
I just think if Memphis could just focus on getting more ball pressure, that would stop. You know, you never want them to be able to complete three passes in a row, and they're able to pass, and then run their offense. And if you can jump a passing lane or put pressure on the player, it might stifle their offense. That's just too easy right there.
Antoinette Miller already a double-double, 15 points, 10 assists. Mentioned she has 5 rebounds as well. Here is Miller. Thomas from 17, no. Reiser falling to the court, got a shot up, but nothing more. And Sifa, probably a foul that the Bearcats could have done without. And the first whistle on Fofo.
Well, Herndon just took that down with a speed that I haven't seen all game. I'd like to see more of that. She has that kind of speed to push it. Just taking them too long to score.
Tigers have lost their last couple of home games. Melissa McFerrin saw that as obviously a step back in some progress they were making this year. Into shoots. And did she step on the baseline? She did. The Tigers are aware that most teams are going to game plan around Davis. And like you said, they need to find other players who can step up. And at least the Tigers are not giving up a lot of second chance points as of late. Just 8 for the ball game for the Bearcats.
Yeah, neither team finding their way here in this fourth quarter yet. And I talked about Cincinnati usually finishing strong. I look for them to kind of pick their tempo up here.
And Davis will head back to the free throw line after the foul by Reiser. Davis today 3 for 5 from the charity stripe. 2 rebounds shy of a double-double with her 13 points.
Yeah, very workmanlike game for Davis. You know, 13 points, shooting 50% from the field. 8 rebounds.
See Reiser come back off. Puckett returning, the sophomore. Puckett's back in with 3 fouls. She's the only Bearcat with 3 fouls or more. Well, mentioned Memphis started off scoring quickly in this ball game back in the first quarter. Their problem was Cincinnati was just draining 3-pointers to stay with them and eventually to establish a lead. We were tied 32 apiece, then Cincinnati went on a 13-0 run right near the end of the first half. Bearcats have been able to grow that advantage now here in the second half.
Yeah, their bench points, they've had 26 bench points. That tells you, you know, we talked about depth, but that's a lot of points to come off your bench.
A lot of that, Nakira Goings. Here is Goings. Sifa.
I like Sifa.
7 points for Fofo.
She just comes off the bench and produces.
And she strips the ball away on the other end. She's taken some charges. She's giving you scoring, and this is the second time that we've seen Herndon a little maligned.
Well, the entire Cincinnati team is physically strong, very quick, you know, very athletic. I mean, all of them have similar body types.
And Schutz running the offense right now. Goes right at Miller. That's a freshman.
That's a nice little pick and roll by Davis. and shoots, and she takes that left-hand dribble over to that side, and look at that. I mean, this is big, little inside-out move. Finishes.
There's no obvious position for Schutz. She's so versatile. Guard, forward, whatever you want to call her. But when she's out there with the basketball, has to be accounted for.
Well, Cincinnati not in a hurry to score.
Rogers trying to rekindle some magic from that three-point line. She made her first four, has missed the last three. And they'll take more of that from Jamira.
Same play, just high post pick and roll, clear out for Schutz.
A 20-point deficit is down to a dozen. Still plenty of time left here in the fourth quarter. Bearcats need an answer as Memphis has hit its last three shots. Oh, Amari Thomas, the matchup with Davis, and she finds Sifa.
Yeah, she's just a good mid-range cleanup shooter.
So Sifa off the bench with 9 points of her own, and again, Jamira Schutz driving to the hole.
Well, they're three out of their last three, and it's been all Schutz. And they can't stop it. This is the quickest offense I've seen them have all day, and maybe they just need to run some sets.
Now 6 of 6 from the charity stripe is the freshman. 21 points now for Jamira. Has added 4 assists, 4 rebounds today. She's been sitting on 3 fouls for a while, but well, Melissa McFerrin went conservative and did what most coaches would do against ECU after 2 quick fouls in the first 5-6 minutes against the Pirates on Saturday. But today, she was not going to sit one of her key players offensively. Trusting the freshman not to pick up another whistle. Thomas finds an opening. And she'll go to the free throw line after Schutz was late to close. And just as I was bragging on Jamira, that's the way things work. That's her fourth foul.
That showed a lot of discipline for Cincinnati. Getting it inside. She's just going to go right at that body of Schutz and draw the foul.
That's where if you're one of Jamira's teammates, you should be raising your hand saying, it was me. I don't know how often that works.
No, it doesn't.
Thomas. Especially not with our veteran crew of Denise Brooks, Maj Forsberg, and Natasha Kamey. Foot race the other way. Sifa with double digits off the bench tonight. And there was a whistle with a free throw coming up.
Well, that was super crafty. I think she actually passed it to herself off the dribble. Here she gets it off the steal, takes it, kind of throws it around the other defender and right to the hole.
Yeah, I think you said it right. She sent that ball right around Schutz. 77-61.
Question. Hey, thanks, Lincoln. I have one last question for our viewers today, and that's their pick for MVP. We have a lot of great options here at today's game. Maybe Nakira Goings with her 5 3-pointers. You have to think if Memphis were to make the comeback, Jamira Schutz in the equation. Give us your answers in the comments below, and we'll let you know who gets our pick at the end of the game. Lincoln?
Jessica, we'll have a chance to talk to your winning head coach and one of your key players at the conclusion of this one. Right now, Bearcats hanging on to a 16-point lead.
This is our game, our moment, our time. We work hard and play harder. We stay loyal to the game and to our team. We are power, American power. The American, powered by determination. More than 7,000 student athletes rising to become champions in 22 different sports at 13 esteemed institutions across 11 states. 360,000 students and 2.6 million alumni rise up in celebration of a Power Six conference known as the American, powered by determination.
Dominance for a fourth straight year.
Queso from 30.
Unbelievable.
And be able to celebrate the second championship.
There's the record breaker. They are the champions of the American.
A reminder what is still to come, as we got to see Melissa McFerrin's group last weekend, tonight, and we're going to see them one more time this upcoming weekend as they take on Tulane in New Orleans. Just a quirk in our schedule. We're getting to see all these teams multiple times. But Tigers here in the month of February. Temple and SMU will close out our American Digital Network schedule in Dallas as Aaliyah Butts collides with Alicia Froehling for the final time for those two seniors, unless they meet in the conference tournament.
Well, Cephas come off the bench and dialed them up for 12 points. And that with Goings, that's 31 points off the bench with two players. Five players in double figures right now for Cincinnati, which is kind of their trademark, and that's what makes them really special.
Schutz and Davis have 37 of Memphis's 61 points so far. Empty-handed this trip down, and Miller beaten by the rim. That's the benefit of, again, home court advantage. I like Miller's philosophy. I don't mind a reset if I kick this ball, as long as I can slow you down one way or another.
Hands up.
Numbers the other way, and Reiser has it poked away by Stinson, who avoids committing the foul.
Yeah, just...
Let's see if I'm wrong on that, if they do get the foul. Yep, they got it.
Yeah, just came from behind. But just, you know, inadvertent pass with, you know, trying to pass it through the hands of the Cincinnati defender. And that's the transition bucket that Melissa McFerrin didn't want to see.
6 points now for Reiser.
Kind of a slow quarter for both teams. Cincinnati only has 10 points for the quarter. Memphis is trading buckets, but just not enough in the tank.
Final 4 minutes here in regulation. Oh, nice last second dish to Davis. She couldn't capitalize. So again, a reminder, of course, we know since we'll have it here on ADN that up next for Memphis will be a trip to New Orleans. For Cincinnati, as we noted, they continue on the road to Temple this weekend before being back home at Fifth Third's Arena against Tulsa. Cincinnati still with trips to Greenville and New Orleans on their schedule, and a home contest again against USF.
Another bucket by Sifa. She's like, Coach, you need to be putting me in the starting lineup.
She's averaging 7 points a ball game. She has doubled that today.
Everything just looks real easy for her right now.
It's not just offense, but defense. Including right there, trying to pluck one away. Ties it up, takes it away. A fresh shot clock with the change in possession. And Thomas now with the rebound. Gets it clear.
4-on-1.
There were, as you noted, 4 black jerseys, just 1 pink jersey. And Cincinnati could not take advantage for that moment. They do manage to still have a 21-point lead. As back to the bench, Asia Jones, just the fourth time we've seen her this year. It was just for a brief moment. Senior who's really seen the last couple of years since transferring from UT Martin plagued by injuries. The Bearcats less than 3 minutes away from improving to 8-3. They know they'll remain in the top three of this conference for at least another week. And Houston is hanging in the thick of things there in the top four seeds. Big comeback on Sunday. Sunday there were a couple of dramatic games. Some head scratchers and some impressive finishes here in the American. It's always fun to see the standings as they look when you enter a Monday and see how this league is continuing to shape out. Obviously this year, UCF, Coach Abe, the job she's done in Orlando in just 3 years already has affected many other teams in this league. And then the other headline this year is the fact that USF, with all of its injuries, is not among the cream of the crop this year. That's not going to be the case for long once they get healthy again for next year, with so many young players getting experience this season for Coach Fernandez. Shoots, goes inside for a closer look, and they will send Jamira to the free throw line.
Yeah, shoots just goes in the middle of that zone and bodies him up and draws the foul. But yeah, I agree. I think that, you know, we talked about kind of we needed to get through the season a little bit, and now we're towards the end of the conference season, and it's clearly showing the pack is separating, you know, Cincinnati, UCF, obviously on top with UConn. And then it's you know, the Houstons, and you're not sure who the fourth and fifth and sixth seed's going to be, but the top and the bottom are definitely separating.
Well, of course, near the bottom, you have SMU and Wichita State, two of the youngest teams in the nation. Wichita State playing 9 freshmen. SMU has 7 freshmen, average age 19 years old, the entire roster, with just the one senior in Frohlin. Inside to Thomas, speaking of freshmen, again, last year's top freshman, and the American has answered it up with no sophomore slump this year for Imari, averaging almost 14 points a ball game. Thomas today, 12 points. One of 5 Bearcats in double-digit scoring.
Yeah, Memphis was originally picked 11th in the league, so, you know, obviously they've had some highs and lows. I think if they can just really focus on their defense and get up and down the floor a little bit better, they are talented. I agree with what they were saying. Melissa was saying this team's capable. It's just they, you know, basketball's a game of runs, and they let a few runs go the other way, and they dig a hole.
Angel Reiser had that last score. She has 9 points now, the only starter not in double figures for the Bearcats. Of course, Goings off the bench in double figures. Leads them with 19 for the team high.
Yeah, that's a little bunny shot you have to make. You know, that's those kind of shots are the ones that Memphis is missing, and that's where you start to get separation against a team like Cincinnati.
Yeah, Cincinnati has just been able to grow its lead here in the fourth quarter, up to a 21-point margin. Well, Memphis did a lot of things well early in this ball game, but they've been trying to catch up and match Cincinnati shot for shot. Memphis still shooting 44%, but Cincinnati's been even better on the road. It has not been as much about the three-pointers for Cincinnati here in the second half, but they've been able to keep Memphis at a distance.
Yeah, Memphis gives up a few more points than they should, and tonight is a good reason. I mean, if you give up 86 points at home, it's not what you really want from your defense. And I think just getting back to some basics and really guarding the ball harder and focusing on the defensive end, they would stop the bleeding a little bit more.
Memphis last year, again, ousted by Tulane in the conference tournament. We saw Cincinnati beat Tulsa in their first matchup last year in the conference tournament before losing to UConn. They would go on to the WNIT, face Michigan State in East Lansing. A minute left here in regulation. Lincoln Rose, Angela Beck, Jessica Benson with you here on the American Digital Network. Big thanks to our entire crew in Memphis. You know, We're told we get to spend at least 15 days of the year together throughout the basketball season. Yes. We always look forward to it. And as long as it feels like we have to wait for it to get started, all of a sudden it's nearly over and a flash.
I was thinking that myself. It was like this broadcast season just as it's gone fast.
I've enjoyed seeing at least two games a week here on the American Digital Network. I've also enjoyed seeing the conference coverage as a whole continue to grow, even if it's not with ADN, but with a variety of other regional and national partners. Some great competitive basketball, as is evident when you look at the standings and just how tight so much of it is. And Davis have to give her a chance to land, so Sifa will be whistled for the foul. Just her second.
Yeah, one of the most effective things that Memphis has done is that short corner right there. They get the short corner, and then they're able to isolate Davis right there on the low block and really get her deep in the paint.
It was a game where Chelsea Warren got the start, but Sifa wound up playing 20 minutes, 14 points. We only saw Warren for about 7 minutes today.
One more rebound for Davis, and she's got a double-double.
So they'll probably keep playing her.
Think?
For the rest of the year. Maybe even for two more years after that.
Lots of fouls here late in the quarter.
Just about 2 seconds separating the two clocks. Fofo already in double digits, has 14 points.
Well, Cincinnati has to be really happy coming in and getting this very solid win on the road from anybody. It's hard to do. And they did it just by playing four really good quarters, by getting balanced scoring, limiting their turnovers, being effective in their, you know, in the little things that make you good. Their shooting was on spot on, and their three-point shooting was outstanding.
Inside to Davis. She has 21 points. Second only to Jamira Schutz, who had 24 before picking up her fifth foul a little bit earlier here in the fourth quarter. That'll do it. Cincinnati now 16-8 on the year, 8-3, more importantly, in the American, as they maintain a tight grip on third place in this conference. And they sweep the Memphis Tigers in their two regular season meetings. Stick around in just a moment. Jessica will have a chance to check back in with Michelle Clark Hurd, head coach of the Bearcats, along with one of the many impressive student athletes we saw here today. And it is looking like it's going to be one of the young women with a double-double in Antoinette Miller. Let's go ahead and check in with Jessica, who's with Coach.
Thanks, Lincoln. Coach, for the second game in a row, five players scoring in double figures, a huge 37 points off your bench. Just how good is your depth right now?
They're playing really well, and we're really proud of our chemistry. I think we're getting better and better, and they're just having fun playing together. So I was really proud of how well we shot the ball in the first half, then we came out the second half and just kept playing together.
To get this kind of road win, road wins matter all year long, but this time of year, this kind of full court performance, how much does that mean to you guys?
It means a lot, and it just says how much this team is growing. And in order to come on the road and win a game like this and play to this caliber, I'm just really proud of this group.
Thank you, Coach. Going to go ahead and introduce now our MVP for today, Antoinette Miller. She had a double-double in points and assists. You had five players scoring in double figures. Your teammates putting in the work, too. How helpful is it for you to know it's a full team experience out there?
It's very helpful. I think that makes it very hard to prepare for us because, you know, we have so many pieces, and you can't just prepare for one person. So I think we use that to our advantage, and we really try to execute when we the game plan with that.
As you've seen this team continue to grow throughout this season, what heights do you think you guys can still reach out there?
I think if we continue to play with confidence and follow the game plan, you know, coach really make sure we prepare for each game. As long as we execute and follow the game plan, that I think that we can really be great. So that's just really up to us.
Great. Thanks so much, Antoinette. I'll go ahead and send it back to you, Lincoln.
Thank you.
Thank you. Her final line, 15 points, 11 assists, 6 rebounds for Miller. For the Bearcats, again, the surprising number, this is just their fourth win away from home this year on a true away game. But they are going to have their final 5 games with 3 on the road and 2 at home. They'll continue to have chances to make that number look even prettier. Cincinnati with the win in Memphis, able to hold off the Tigers and hold on to 3rd place in the American. For our entire crew, Angela Beck, Jessica Benson, I'm Lincoln Rose. Good night from Memphis. When we see you next, we'll be in New Orleans on Saturday, Tigers and Tulane.